Hello everyone. Last class we learned about the introduction to spam filters, that is, what do you mean by spam and what is the purpose of sending spam email and how to prevent spam email into the inbox using different kinds of spam filters. Today we are going to learn about why linear regression algorithm not works for the spam filter. And similarly, we have a k nearest neighbor also. Why? Whether it works good for the spam filtering or not. And finally, neo Bayes algorithm used for the spam filtering and how it works to filter the spam emails. Here, the question is, why won't linear regression work for the spam filtering? We know that we have 10,000 of emails. Let us consider we are given 10,000 of emails, each labeled as a spam and not a spam. And even in the emails, the vocabulary of the email ranges lakhs of words in total. So this is about the training data set. So that is m is equal to 10,000 number of training samples, that is 10,000 emails, and n is equal to 1 lakh words, that is number of features. So if we want to represent a single email by a feature vector, we can represent using binary vector by saying that spam or a not spam. That's also we can do. The question here is, should you use linear regression on the labeled emails to build a spam filter? You know that spam filter means it prevents spam email getting into the inbox. So that is it possible using linear regression we can prevent a spam mails entering into the inbox? The answer is no. Why it is no? You see here, this particular problem, that is, we want to filter this spam, that is, the given email is a spam or not. So that we want to do. Here, thing is that our target vector is binary. Means our labels are binary. If 0 is labeled to the male, it is not a spam. If it is labeled to the 1, then it is a spam. That is, our target vector is here binary. So here we will not get a 0 or 1 using linear regression. So in case of linear regression, we are not labeling it as a either 0 or 1. So there we are considering dependent and independent variable. We are using the fitting a model, we are estimating the parameters in the linear regressions. So that is why linear regression is aimed at modeling continuous output values, not the binary output value. The output of linear regression is we get a continuous value, but here is the output is what? Binary. So output means in case of regression is we have one is dependent variable, another is independent variable. Those values are in terms of continuous values. But here is what we have in a binary. So that's why the linear regression algorithm won't work for the spam filtering. And coming to k-nearest neighbor, you know that the k-nearest neighbor is, it is, takes a distance measures to take this to measure the nearest value of the test instance. So that is taking test instance with distance between the test instance with all the instances in the data set, then finalizing the k nearest neighbors. Among that k nearest neighbors, it will take based on the majority, then it finalizes the test data is labeled as a majority of vote. Okay. So here, this is, we have in 10,000 emails, lakhs of words, but using k nearest neighbor, we need to take a distance between lakhs of words of all the mails of thousands of or 10,000s of emails. It takes computing time is very large. So that is why it requires lots of computational work for this particular problem using k nearest neighbor. So it is also called the curse of dimensionality. So this is a problem with k nearest neighbor. And you know that the k nearest neighbor, in k nearest neighbor always will do the online training, not a offline training. In some of the supervised learning algorithm, so the training is done once, then so we'll do only testing. If the training data set changes, then we'll go for the training, otherwise we'll not go for the training process. So here in k nearest neighbor, every time we need to train it, that's why we call it as a online training. So it requires lot of time to compute it. So that's why k nearest neighbor is not good for the spam filtering. So that's why it makes KNN poor algorithm in this particular problem. Coming to naive Bayes, so before going to the naive Bayes algorithm, we'll study one problem. That is, let us say we were testing for a rare disease where 1% of the entire population is infected, means it is disease. We have a highly sensitive and specific test which is not quite perfect. This is a given statement, and they said that 99% of sick patients test a positive. 99% of this entire, 1% of the, this 1% is of the population is infected, means 1% of the population is sick. Out of that, 99% sick patients tested positive. And similarly, 99% of healthy patients test a negative. Okay. The question here is, given that a patient tests a positive, if the patient is tested as a positive, what is the probability that the patient is actually sick? The patient is tested a positive, then what is the probability that the patient is actually is sick? This we need to compute based on the given thing, all these values. So we'll go for here. So it is represented in a tree diagram. So let us assume that the population size is 10,000 people. Okay. Out of 10,000 people, 1% sick, 1% is infected. So that is 100 people are sick out of 10,000. So the statement, one more statement, they said that here 99% of the sick patients test a positive. So here this is a sick patient, 100 people are sick. Out of this 100 people, 99% tested positive. That is 99 people are tested positive. If 99 are tested positive, the only 1% is negative. That is 1%. Okay. And coming to here in the previous, so if 1% is sick out of entire population, we came to know that, so 99% are healthy people. Okay. So that is 99% healthy people means 9,900 people are healthy. So one more statement they said that here, so 99% here, 99% of the healthy patients test negative. Here 99% healthy people. So 99% of healthy people tested negative. So this is 99% people or healthy people tested negative. So 99% of 9,900 is 9,801 people. Okay. So you know this one. By knowing this, you can say that if 99% test negative, 1% test is obviously it is positive. That is 99 people are positive. So if you observe this diagram, you can conclude that if you tested a positive, in other words, you are equally likely to be healthy or sick. Because here 99% tested positive, 99% tested negative, the answer is 50%. So this is what you can conclude, that even though if you tested a positive, you may be 50%, you can say you equally, you may be healthy or you may be sick. So this same problem you can solve using Bayes law with beautiful notations, that is probability notations. See here, we have two events x and y. It is represented by probability, the probability of x, probability of y. Then we have a joint probability, that is both happen, probability of x comma y. And there is a conditional probability, it is denoted by probability of x given y. Here y is input, x is output. How to, you need to say that the probability of x given a y means y is the input, x is the output. So the joint probability, that is probability of x comma y, is defined as the probability of x given y into y, or else the probability of y given x into the probability of x. This is what the joint probability. Either you can write in this form or you can write in this form. So using this joint probability definition, we can define Bayes law. So that is, see here, the probability of y given x is equal to the probability of x given y into the probability of y divided by x. So this is, in the previous, you know that this one, probability of x comma y. So you can write the probability of y given x, this one is equal to, so you can write here the probability of x. So this becomes what? Bayes law. The probability of y given x is equal to the probability of x given y into the probability of y divided by the probability of x. This is called Bayes law. So that is written here, the probability of y given x is equal to the probability of x given y into y divided by x, assuming that the probability of x is not equal to 0. So it is called a Bayes law. This is called a Bayes law. So we'll denote y to what? Sick. Y is represented as a sick and x is represented as a positive. Tested a positive. So we'll represent same Bayes law equation in terms of sick and positive. This is the Bayes law. We want to compute what is the probability of sick given a positive. Okay. So the probability of sick given a positive is equal to, as per the Bayes law, the probability of positive given sick into probability of sick divided by the probability of positive. So this is a Bayes law. Okay. We have a value. The probability of positive given sick is what? 99%, that is 0.99. So probability of sick is what? 1%, that is 0.001. The probability of positive is computed in this way. You see here, the probability of positive given a sick into the probability of sick plus the probability of positive given a healthy into the probability of healthy. This is what? Total probability. So the positive given sick is what? It is a 99. Sick is 1%, that is 0.01. The probability of positive given healthy is, you know that it is a 99, this one. And probability of healthy is this one. Oh, sorry, 0.01. So if you compute this value here, you will get 0.50. 50%. Okay. So this is what we'll get from the Bayes' law, similarly as using a tree diagram. Okay. Thank you.